a word that will make us better and to be best of Him. And I pray this word will bless our souls. I will not be the hearer alone, but the doer. At the end of it all, we all will make it to heaven in Jesus' name. Amen. Brethren, our topic tonight says, all things are possible with God. All things are possible with God. So before we take it this way, with God, all things are possible. But the way I titled it tonight is, all things are possible with God. All things are possible when you add God to whatever you are doing. That means without Him in your life, nothing is possible. If you check the dictionary meaning of with means to add to something, to go with, to be with, to allow. That is the meaning of with. With is an added value. Something you add to your life to make meaning. So therefore, the Lord is telling you and I, with Him in our life, with Him in your life, with Him in that situation, if you allow Him to take over it, all things is well. The Bible told us in the book of Matthew chapter 19, Matthew chapter 19, I take it from 24. Or rather 23 for clarity. So then Jesus said unto his disciples, verily I say unto you, that a rich man shall hardly enter into the kingdom of heaven. And again I say unto you, 24, it is easier for a camel to go through the eyes of the needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. And this word puzzled the disciples. This word made the disciples to marvel. What kind of saying is this? This should be a statement that will paralyze humanity. And in verse 25, when his disciples heard it, this one now not even the congregations, the disciples themselves. When his disciples heard it, they were exceedingly amazed. They were exceedingly amazed, saying, who then can be saved? Because everybody are rich in different ways. You might be rich in this, the other one might be rich in the other way. Now, they were comparing to themselves. Because Peter know, in his own way, there's a level that he's rich. Matthew know, in some level, he is rich. The other one know, in some level, he is also rich. So, it became an impossible task for them. And they begin to ask themselves questions. How then can any be saved? But Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men, this is impossible. With men in thy riches, with men in thy conglomerate you have, putting men at the added value in thy riches, you cannot make heaven. Putting men first in that what you are doing, you cannot make heaven. Because you have made men to be your focus in that riches, it is impossible for you to make it to heaven. But it's further said in part B, verse 26, but with God, all things are possible. If you can do yourself good and add God to what you are doing as the added value, as the one that will take preeminence, he said, no matter how rich you are, you will make it to heaven. If you allow Jesus Christ to be the preeminent in thy riches, he said, Peter, it is possible for you to make heaven. No matter how rich you are, no matter how poor you are, without Jesus, heaven is out of the point. You know why? Because even though you are poor, in a little way, you are rich. So therefore, if you take Christ out of that your life, hell is waiting for you. So with man in your life, and without Jesus in your life, nothing is impossible. Nothing is possible. You are in hell already. But with God in your life, with Jesus in your life, all things are possible. To be joyful is possible. To live a better life is possible. To make heaven is possible. So what do? Let us add God and allow Him to be the preeminent in our life. No wonder the Bible told us. This is a reference in the book of 1 Timothy, chapter number 1, chapter 2, verse 9. This was not there. It just came to my memory, my spirit now, as we are here right now. In 1 Timothy, chapter 2, verse 9, it said, in like manner also that men adorn that women adorn themselves in modest apparel. In like manner that women adorn themselves in modest apparel and sobriety, not with. Just like it told us, with God all things are possible. Now, the same which is here. Say, not with braided hair. That means with braided hair, hair is waiting for you. Say, not with. Just like I said, with men, nothing is possible. With men, all things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible. And in this same place, the Lord is telling me to tell you for more explanation, which I never knew before. So tell them now, that I also tell them, not with braided hair. Braided hair should not be an added value to your life. Plaiting of hair must not be an added value to your life. Meaning, with braided hair, hair is waiting for you. Just as with men, you a rich man, you are doomed. Not with braided hair or gold or pearls or costly array. Not with all these things. Meaning, with all these things, you are finished. If you add all these things as an added value to your life, when the Lord have made you a perfect person, the Lord have made you a perfect woman, He has made you a perfect man, you are adding extra things to your life, plating your hair again, making some design, whatever, anyway you do it. Say, with that thing on your hair, you are in hair fire already. Just as with men of God, all things are impossible. The Bible told us in Luke chapter 1, verse 34. Luke chapter 1, verse 34. And I read, then said Mary unto the angel. This is the time that angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and told Mary, you will conceive, you will have a child. And Mary, it baffled Mary. How can this be? Just as when Christ was talking to the disciples just now, it puzzled them. How would this be? And then, in verse 34, then said Mary unto the angel, how shall this be? How can I have a child? How can I do this? See, I know no man. Forgotten even with man in your life, and without God, you can never conceive. With husband, without God in your life, child will never come. If you like, let your husband be a factory of cement that make baby. It can never form. Without God in your life, you cannot have it. And he said, since I have no man in my life. Verse 35. And the angel answered and said unto her, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee. The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore, that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And verse 36. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, aged, and this is the sixth month with her, who called barren. Verse 37. For with God nothing shall be impossible. For with God nothing shall be impossible. Making me to understand, your sister Elizabeth is pregnant. It's not because the husband has gone to school of pregnancy. He has gone to school to make her pregnant, that she's pregnant. For many years, Elizabeth has been with the husband. No, nothing happened. But today, the Holy Spirit has manifested into her life to give birth to a child. So Mary, I am telling you, with your husband by your side and without God, all things are impossible. But with God, if you can only allow God to manifest in you, if you can only allow God in your life, all things are possible. So therefore, Mary, you don't need to be puzzled about this. Let this not be your problem. What you should be thinking is how to allow God to manifest through you. How to allow Jesus to come into my life and do it. Would you allow God to do it? That should be it. Would you allow God to add value to your life? So many people today, they are valueless because they are taking God out of their life. So therefore, virtually everything are impossible. They may have money as paper, but the joy that comes with money is not there. They may have children, but because God is out of them, the joy that comes with children isn't there. They may have chase of cars, but because they have removed God out of their life, the cars have become a burden to them. They don't sleep in the night. They don't have joy in their life. What are they doing with that car? So with God, to be joyful without God, to be joyful is impossible. The Bible told us in the book of Matthew 17, verse 20. Matthew 17, verse 20. Praise Master Jesus. Matthew 17, 20 says, and Jesus said unto them, because of your unbelief, for verily I say unto you, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you shall say unto this mountain, remove to yonder place, hence, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible. First of all, add God to your life and allow faith to walk through you. If you have God in your life, many people have God in their life, but they don't put their faith in that God. They believe God is with them, but when it comes to practice it, they take God off. They bring man in. When a situation arises in their life, they forget about God. They start running helter-skelter for the man. And at that time, you now add man as the added value in your life. Nothing will be done. So therefore, what do we do? As we say, we are born again. In every situation, let us allow God to manifest himself. Let us trust in God. Let us believe in God. As you go with him, you are on the street, you are going with him. You are in the house, you are going with him. When problem comes, let it come as you are with him. And I tell you, nothing shall be impossible. Just a matter of commanding by the authority of him that is with you. As far as God is with you, as you profess, nothing will be impossible for you to do. If only you will trust him. See, many people are born again. There's no doubt about it. When situations arise, they forget about him. But if you and I can just believe that this God that is with us, he can do all things. Nothing is impossible with him. I tell you, there is no situation that you cannot bring down. There's no problem that will come your way that you cannot bring down. Just a matter of pronouncing it. In the name of that God that is with you. Except it's not with you. Except you are not allowing him, you are not allowed him into your life. So if you can have faith with that God who is with you, if you can have belief with that God who is with you, just tell that mountain to move. If you move, what is that mountain in your life right now? Is it mountain of sickness? Mountain of problem? Mountain of barrenness? Whatever mountain it might be, remember the Lord is with you. Remember Jesus is with you. You are born again. You have allowed him into your life. So put your trust in him. Believe he can do all things. Believe there's nothing he cannot do. And take your eyes away from man. With man, virtually all things are impossible. If you raise man up above God, I'm not saying you should not ask man to pray with you. That's why I will tell people, don't tell me to pray for you. Tell me to pray with you. So that my faith and your faith will come together to move the mountain. With the Lord in us, all things will be possible. Because if you are saying, man of God, pray for me. If I come alone, that is you are raising me more than that God in you. And that God will want to disgrace me before you. Okay now, because you have put your trust in this little boy, let me see what he will do. I will pray from today to tomorrow. If God refuses to answer the prayer, it remains undone forever. So therefore, if you come, go come with the Lord. And you say, okay, my brother, come and join me. Let us pray together in the name of this God with me. I, you, and the power of that God in you, everything will be okay. But if you put your trust in a man, thinking this man is anointed, until this man declare, none shall be done, try God. He will disgrace that man in your presence. God, he said, with man of God, all things are impossible. With Apostle Emmanuel in your life, man of the Almighty God in your life, all things are possible. You know why? Because Apostle Emmanuel is less than nothing without God. I am whom I am today because he's with me. Apostle Abraham is who he is today because the Lord is with him. Take God away, we are like bread in water. Match it is gone. Take God away from us, we cannot cross the night. What about now? If God leave us, tonight we sleep, God forbid, we never wake up, what will you do? You will go for another man again, another man of God again. You will not say, because Apostle Man is no more there, I will not pray again. You have to pray. You have to still look for another place to go to. So therefore, you must not put your trust in a man. A man can sleep and never wake up again. With man, with me in your life, man of God in your life, all things are impossible. You will sick and die. You will become barren forever with me in your life without God. That situation will increase and destroy you. With Apostle Emmanuel in your life and without God in you, you will suffer and suffer and suffer and suffer and die in it. You know why? I am limited with so many things. Without God, I am so limited. If I have headache, God forbid, the same God you cannot call upon is the one I will call upon. I have no power to remove headache from myself. I have no power to heal myself. I have no power to do anything. So with me, all things are impossible. But with Jesus Christ, if you can allow him, you make him to be the added value in your life. Number one, not me, not any apostle of this mountain. We are just here as a representative. If who we are representing leave us, we are finished. That is what you should know. Hey, that man is a great man of God. That man is a great apostle. Hey, remove the great God. Remove God in it. The great man is finished. I know one great man of God. Let us call that great man of God. Remove that God. The God that's supposed to be great. You remove him, Let us pray, great man of God. Where is God now? If you remove that God, the great man is finished. So what do? Allow God to take preeminence. Say, all things are possible with him. And nothing is possible with a man. Mark chapter 9, verse 23 says, Jesus says unto him, just as he said unto you right now, Daddy Jesus Christ, he said unto you wherever you are all over the world, if thou can believe in him, trust him, let it be number one in your life, all things are possible to them that believe in him. All things, everything you ever think of, are possible with such a person. Now, you now ask yourself now, why is that thing still there? Because it's two ways. It's either he's not there yet in your life, you are only fabricating, you are only an hypocrite, or you don't believe him. He's there, you are only using him as a furniture. You are only using him as a walking tool. But you don't believe he can do it. You only call him just to identify with you. People are saying, I am born again. Let me also use him to say, I am born again. But if we actually allow him to be with us and we believe him, I tell you, all things shall be possible. It's like you marry a wife. She's not useful to you. Everybody knows her as your wife. But within you and herself in the house, you know both of you are tyrants. No joy in the home. You are only using her as a furniture. The only time you need her is that time. But any other thing, she is useless. That's how many people take God. You only use him as an identity. Let me be identified with such people who are born again. But you don't know what that God can do. You have not seen what he can do because you have not tried him. Because you don't believe to that extent, you cannot move more than your faith. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Whatever mountain your faith cannot move, cannot be moved. If you can trust in that God in your life, that you said you believe, that you said you is in you, everything is possible. The Bible in Mark 9, 23 to 24. And straight away, the father of the child, if you get home, read all Mark chapter 9. You see how the disciples messed up. Christ was with them, but they never believed he can do it. Christ was always with them. They know that Christ is with them, but they don't have faith in him. They don't have trust in him. I mean, physically, he was with them those days. But yet, they could not move mountain through him. And straight away, the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe. Help thou my unbelief. Two things. He knows I believe in you because I see you doing it. But I don't believe you can do my own. Okay, now. I believe you have done it for others. I believe you. But in this my case, I don't believe you. Help my unbelief in this one now. You believe people are giving testimony. This morning we have many testimonies that came. You believe God can do that, but in your own case, you don't believe it. That's why even some men of God, when they are sick, they run to chemists and start buying medicine. They believe God can use them to heal somebody. But when it comes to their own, the faith is gone. That is the problem of man. You believe he can do for somebody just like this man. Jesus, I believe you. I've heard what you have done. I've heard lame walk. I've heard things happen. But in this my case, I don't believe you. Help my unbelief in this one now. Because the problem my son is having is too much. I don't think you can do this. In this very one, Lord, I need your help. I don't believe. If your disciples couldn't do it, I don't think you can do it. Because they were calling your name when they were praying. It didn't happen. Do you have any other name to call now? So then, I don't believe. I believe somebody vomited. I believe long-term mercies begin to flow. But in this one is cancer. I don't believe God can heal cancer. Hey, but I'm here to announce to you. This same God that you have cured cancer, you have done it before, right here on this mountain. If you can believe the Lord can heal headache, in the same body, if you can take away headache, it can take away cancer, it can cancel cancer. If you believe that the Lord, that woman that testified, I got a job by the power in God, also believe him. He can also give you that document. He can do all things. Just a matter of believing in your own situation. This man had to cry out. Instead for you to cry out, sister, you have been believing God to other people. You call others. Hey, sister, I know of a place where God answers prayer. I know of a place where they preach righteousness, and when they pray there, God answers. And you are inviting them, but within you, that thing is still there. You believe he can do it for that woman. But when it comes to you, your belief fails you. You need help tonight. The Lord wants to help you. Just as this man cried out, Father, I believe you can do everything. But is this my own? My heart is failing me. My mind is failing me. I don't know what to say this. This situation is too much for me. I know you are here, Jesus Christ. But I don't know if you can do it. Please help my unbelief. That's why most times when I pray, I say, Lord, to me, I believe I am doing it rightly now, but I don't know. If I'm being hypocritical, please help me. If I'm not real enough, my mind is telling me I'm real now, but you know all things. If I'm not real enough, make me real so that I will not just make noise with this person and the situation remains the same. There are people like this man on this mountain. You can believe for other people and it will work for them. People you are inviting, things are happening in their life. Because of the belief you built in them, they came here and they are blessed. You give them that Jesus Christ in you. They handle him with care. And they came. They believe that woman that we talk about in the morning. Somebody told her what is happening here. She came with that mind. The man that person, I don't know who gave her, the man that person built her. Immediately she connected. The demon started manifesting. The demon that had been pouring sand upon her for the past 30 years. No sleeping. Things are upside down. The first time in the night that she had rest. After that time, the sand never poured her again. Somebody built the faith in her. You'll be surprised, Apostle Peter, that person has been on this mountain for the past 6 months. She did not believe on herself. She don't believe it can be done in her life. I'm talking to myself also. It's time to start working on ourselves. This man had to cry out, Jesus, help me here. Daddy, help me here. You have done it for others. But in my case, I see some impossibility. And when he cried out, Father, help my unbelief, Jesus Christ has to first of all heal that sickness of unbelief. In sickness, you are sick when you don't believe in him. Father, help me. He has to first of all cure him before he cured the son. Many of us on this mountain, including some of the ministers here, we need healing from the Lord. We need to be healed from our unbelief. So that people we are inviting will not be coming and be testifying. And tell me, you'll be angry of those people you are bringing. What is happening? I brought you testify. I brought you testify. What is happening? This is the key. You believe for them, but you don't believe in your own situation. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible told us.
Hallelujah.
It told us in Isaiah 41 verse 10. Fear thou not. No matter the situation, fear thou not, for I am with you. I am with you. Don't fear that situation. He is with you. Don't be dismayed. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. You have called me, my daughter. I have come. Why can't you just believe in me? Why are you still still living in fear. If you know with me, you can still be afraid. Why do you call on me? If you know with me, you can still be living that way. Why do you call me? Now he's telling you now, my sister, my brother, my great apostle, my great ministers, the minister of God in this mountain, fear thou not, for the Lord is with us. Be not dismayed, for he is our God. We have called him. He has come. Let us trust him. He can do it. With him, all things are possible. Yea, I will uphold thee. No, he said, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. He has come to help me and you. He has come to strengthen us. Yea, I will uphold thee with my righteous right hand of righteousness. My righteous right hand of righteousness. That is to say, if the Lord wants to use his righteous right hand to help you, you must also be righteous. Righteousness plus righteousness equals to perfection. If one side is righteous, the other side is filthy, it cannot work. This is another key now. I will uphold thee with my righteous right hand. The Lord wants to stretch his hand to you. That hand you are stretched to him must also be righteous. Else, if it bounce back, it cannot, it will repair. Praise Master Jesus. It will repair back. So for his right hand to deliver you, your old right hand must also be righteous. For a righteous God to work in me, to work in you, we must also be righteous. First of all, let him be in you, with him in your life. When he comes, believe him, trust him, and you must be righteous. You must be holy. He said, the holy thing that will come instead of you, his name shall be called Jesus. How can that holy thing come into an unholy thing? It's not possible. A holy womb cannot carry holy Jesus. It's not possible. No wonder he had to come through virgin. That holy healing power cannot enter into a holy body to heal you. That is another problem. That holy blessing cannot come into an unholy person to bless you. Now, who will you glorify? You will glorify the devil. As far as you are still dwelling in sin, all the glory in your life is of the devil. So that's why he told us in Matthew chapter 6, verse 7. Give not that which is holy to the dog, nor cast a pearl to swine, else they will trample under it and tear you apart. That is the problem we are having. Holy blessing cannot manifest in an unholy person. So let us be holy, and blessing will come. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible told us in Mark chapter 11, verse 22, Mark 11, verse 24, rather, says, Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, if you can desire it, he said he can deliver it. Apostle Peace, tell my people, if they can desire that thing, and they pray about it, believe him, he said it shall be done. Mark 11, 24. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, first of all, desire it. Desire it. Next thing, pray about it. Not until a man pray for you. You can ask the man I have said before to pray with you. Believe you have received them. Believe you have got it there, because he that will do it is with you. And you shall have them. Jesus Christ speaking. He have never lied before. He will not start lying. Who are we for Christ to start lying to make us to be happy? No. He can't lie to make me happy. Who am I? I'm not the clay again. I'm not that man he made from the clay. What do I have? What can I give him anything again? He's already at the peak of his glory. I cannot add anything to him anymore. So, why should he lie to me? Why should he lie to make me happy? So, therefore, sister, brother, you have called him. It's your life now. Say, everything you ever desire, Believe it. Pray about it. It will be done. Take man out of the picture. Let Christ be in the picture. Pray, and it shall be done. Hannah took away every other person. Hannah forgot the husband. He forgot Eli as a priest. He went to the temple and prayed. Even Eli had to say, "You are drunk, woman. What is wrong with you?" And he said, "I am not drunk. I have a desire in my heart. I have something bothering me." Can I get that on First Samuel chapter 1:1-2? Praise Father Jesus. I have a desire in my heart. And I am here to pray it out. I believe he will do it now. I've been coming to Shiloh every month to eat and drink. I will just only come and cry. But in this one, I have a desire. Before I was coming, I have a desire in my heart that this time it's not going to pass me by. I don't know who are you. I mean, who you are this month right now. You came without anything in your heart, desiring anything. Start desiring something now. Because it will be done for you. Just believe. Praise Master Jesus. Just trust him.
Hallelujah.
Hannah took away Eli. Say, my husband, this one is beyond you. I've been with you for years. Maybe 10 years or 15 years. Nothing have happened. That means, even though I am with you for 100 years, without Jesus Christ, it cannot be done. But today, I'm going to meet him one-on-one. Face-to-face. It was when she did that, Elena came in and said, "My daughter, go with this man. It is well with you." She did not put Eli first. She did not put apostle first. She did not put that great man of God first. She forgot them and not used them to declare. Just as that woman that day, she was in pain for many months or so. Messages have not come. What is this? Maybe poison in her stomach. What is this? And she was praying earnestly. "Oh God, deliver me today. I have a desire. Father, this message must start today. And Lord, lay it in my heart to declare it as you are going now. There will be flow. You will vomit." And she shouted her amen. Just as Eli declared. And when she got home, she began to vomit them out. And that message begin to flow immediately. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
With God in your life, all things are possible. With God in you, even minus Apostle Emmanuel, all things are possible. When did I know you? You have been living. For the past 30 years, 10 years, 15 years, I have not been with you. Have you not been living? Have I been the one to take care of you? No. That same God is here alive. Don't say without Apostle, "If I am nothing without him." Eli was nothing without God. Eli will pronounce without God performing it. It's just a pronouncement. It cannot be. Nothing will happen. I will declare him to not be delivered. I will pronounce it will not be performed until God do it. If you can take me out of the picture now and say, "God, it's you." Take Apostle Abraham out of the picture and say, "God, it's you." And I tell you, it will lay in our hearts of the prayer we pray. And by declaring it, it shall be done. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible told us in Jeremiah chapter 23, I'm closing because time. Jeremiah 32, verse 17. Say, "Ah, Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heavens and the earth by thy great power, and stretched out thy arm, and there is nothing too hard for you to do." Jeremiah knows this. Do you know this? "Ah, Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heavens and the earth, everything are made by him, by thy great power, and stretched out arm, and there is nothing too hard for you to do." He can do all things, brother. All things are possible with him. There is nothing he cannot do. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
With men, all things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible. What shall we say then to this thing? What shall we then say to that thing now? If God be for us, what sickness can be against us? What government can be against us? What barrenness spirit can be against us? What is that thing that can be against you? Nothing. Romans chapter 8, verse 31. What shall we then say to this thing and possibly be? If God be for us, who can be against us? In that barrenness, it cannot be. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Mm. Job had to say, I know that that can do everything, and that not thought can be withholding from thee. Whatever you desire, God can do it. That thought in your heart, he sees it, he can do it. That desire in your heart, believe it, and it will be done. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Remember our Sister Sarah? Everything was upside down for her. But a time came, there was a pronouncement from the Lord. In Genesis 18, verse 14. Get to read it. Say, by this time next year, I will come again and I will meet Sarah having a child. I paraphrase. Genesis 18, verse 14. Praise Master Jesus. And he said to us, behold, I am the Lord thy God, for all flesh is there. I am the God. Behold, I am the Lord, thy God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for thee? Too hard for me? Christ is talking here right now. Jeremiah 32, verse 27. Answer that question. If your answer is no, that problem is solved already in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is a take-home package for you now. Isaiah 46, verse 10. Declare the end from the beginning, and from ancient time, the things that not are, did I not are. Please let me go to my Bible so I will not quote what is not there. It's a take-home package so that you will get it very, very right. Isaiah 46, verse number 10. Isaiah 46, verse 10, I read. They declare the end from the beginning, and from ancient time, the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure. The Lord will do everything he has said concerning you. Everything he has said concerning you. I don't know.
Amen.
If you don't have vision before now, ask the Lord, speak to me. I want to know what you have said concerning me. So he has declared it from the ancient time. His counsel stand, and he will do all that he has said concerning you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is the word of the Lord tonight. And the Lord bless the word in our heart in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Brother, sister, you are dead, you are not born again, you are out of it. No matter what you think you are, what you think you have now, you and that thing, you are wasted. Say after me if you want to be useful from now on. Say, Lord Jesus, I've come to you tonight. Have mercy upon me. For I was on my way to hell. Forgive me all my sins. Wash me clean. Come into my life today. I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I am born again today. All things are passed away and all things have become new. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name.